In this MATLAB-based simulation environment, I am going to discuss about audio quantization. So after the initialization with respect to clear all, close all, and CLC, the first function that I'm going to use to read the audio file is simply audio read. And over here we have the name of the audio, right? And this is simply an audio file of a small duration, which is mono, so it is not stereo. And this is available in .wav, that is wave format. So the output of audio read is going to give us y and the sampling frequency fs. So in line 8, I'm going to extract the information about this audio file using audio info and then store it in a variable which is audio info. Next, for time domain analysis, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this info and set it to info.duration, that is duration of this audio file, and based on that duration and using the sampling frequency, I'm going to set the time index. After that, I'm going to adjust the time index from 1 to end minus 1. So as the first part of simulation, I'm going to plot using figure 1 and the command subplot 211, and I'm going to plot y, which is coming out of the audio read, with respect to t, and then I'm going to x label time, y label as simply original audio signal. Also, I'm going to play this audio signal by means of a vector y coming from the audio read and using the sampling frequency also available over here, right? So until line 17, where I have set the keyboard, let us run the simulation.
We will have so much winning if I get elected that you may get bored with winning.
This is simply a random audio signal that I have extracted out from the internet. Okay, so over here we have the time domain plot. You can observe that the overall duration of this plot is just less than 6 seconds. And the amplitudes are quite low, it is between minus 0.5 to 0.5. Note that the number of quantization levels in this audio signal is set to 256. So there are 8 bits and 256 levels to quantize the y-axis. So as a first step, in what follows, I'm going to reduce these quantization levels, which are 256, to 16, right? So I set a variable which is L equal to 15. Note that the quantization levels are 16, but the index is from 0, 1, 2, and terminating at 15, right? So the quantization levels in what follows is simply 16, right? And I'm also introducing a variable which is V, and this is just going to identify the maximum value in Y over here, right? And after that, in 22, 23, I am going to perform linear quantization. And for that, I have used a function which is quantize. And the first argument of that quantize is simply y coming out of the audio read function at line 7. And after that, in the second argument, we have a multi-threshold. So this is a function, an inbuilt MATLAB function, multi-threshold. So what it is going to do is it is going to take this vector y and partition it into L, where L is set to 15. So there will be 15 partitions in multi-threshold. So the last argument in quantize is the code book, and for that you need an array of element which is 1 greater than the second argument. So in the second argument, there were 15 elements. So over here, we have 16 elements. So this is generally the third argument is the code book. And the only difference is that we have appended V, that is one element at the end of multi-threshold, right? So this is going to be 15 and this is going to be 16 elements. And after that, I'm going to use the subplot 212 plot T with respect to quants, that is quantizations expressed over here. And then perform some labeling and play the sound, and finally again use a keyboard. So let us increment the simulation by one step until line 28.
We will have have so much winning if I get elected that you may get bored with winning.
The level of distortion in the second sound is quite evident, and this is also observed in the time domain plot. Note that in the time domain plot, now you can observe the patterns of levels. So now we have 16 levels on y-axis, that is amplitude for quantized output signal, as compared to a 256 level original signal, that is 256 levels at the amplitude. To observe further, let us zoom the quantized signal, and you can observe that there are levels. So this is a level, another level is over here, the third level is over here. So it is taking discrete values at the amplitude, as compared to continuous as observed over here. This in fact is also not continuous, but the levels are quite, but the number of levels are quite high, that is 256. So presently we have performed quantization, that is linear quantization, from line 22 to line number 27, right? So in what follows, I'm going to demonstrate a non-linear quantizer or non-linear quantization, that is companding, compression and expansion. So for that, the law parameter for both mu and a law is set to 255. More description about mu law and a law are available in the previous session. So specifically for the mu law, as a first step, we are going to compand, and in that companding, the function that we use is simply a compressor, right? And we have used the mu law, so we have a mu law compressor. At the same time, for a law, again we use the same function, that is compand, but instead of mu compressor, in line 44 for a law we have an a compressor, right? For compand, we set the signal, which is y, and we use the law parameter, which we have set as 255, and the maximum value of y, and lastly the compressor. The output of this compand is going to give me a compressed signal, and the compression is in terms of amplitude, right? So next, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this compressed signal in a linear quantizer. So in 36 I have a linear quantizer, and similarly for a law, again I have a linear quantizer in line 45, right? And we have the first argument, which is compressed mu or compressed a, right? And after that, multi-threshold, and then multi-threshold yl appended with maximum value, which is v, maximum of y, which is v, right? So this is our code book, this is partitions, and again line 36 is for mu law, and line 45 is expressing the quantization for a law. So for expansion, we again use the same command that was used for compression, which is compand. So we use again compand here. We use quants mu, that is quantizations for mu law, the law parameter, which is set to 255, the maximum value of this signal. Originally it was compressed using the mu law, now it is expanded using the mu law, right? And similar step follows for the A law in line 46. So lastly, in figure 2, I'm going to subplot expanded mu, that is this signal, with respect to time. Similarly, in line 47, that is subplot 212, we have the nonlinear quantization based on A law. So let us proceed further with the simulation. Over here we have the quantization based on mu law, and the quantization based on a law. So for comparison, we have used distortion as a metric, and this distortion is simply a mean square error, and this distortion is appearing for linear quantizer in the function itself. If you can observe over here, we have distortion linear, so this quantizer or this function is going to give us the distortion at the output. But for mu law and a law, we have used a simple function to compute the mean square errors. And what we have done is we have simply used the expanded mu, which is over here, but this is a row vector, right? But at the same time, y is a column vector. So what we have done is we have transposed this expanded mu so that we can subtract expanded mu with y, right? Again, this was originally a row vector. Now we have converted into a column vector. So we have squared each element and divided by the overall length of y to normalize it. So we get mean square error for the distortion in mu law and distortion in a law. So in the present simulation setup, let us observe which of these quantizers, that is linear quantization and non-linear quantization based on mu law and a law, has performed better. So the results are over here. For linear quantization, the value is very, very small, whereas we have higher values for mu law and a law. So what this means is that the non-linear quantization has in fact inflicted more distortion on the output SNR as compared to a linear quantizer. So this is quite undesirable. Let us understand why this has happened with the first figure. Now this is our first figure. Observe that most of the amplitudes are quite low. It is between minus 0.5 to plus 0.5. So all of these amplitudes are quite low. So the reason for that is most of the audio files that are available on the internet have already undergone some kind of pre-processing, which includes compression by either mu law and a law to a certain extent. So this is the reason that the distortion for mu law and a law is more than as compared to the linear quantizer. So just to make an argument over here, what I'm going to do next is I am going to create a signal using the original audio which has high amplitudes, and that reflects on most of the audio signals that we would record, and then perform the quantization on it. So for such, let me include a new function here, that is the new y, which is indicating the audio file. So this y is equivalent to say 8 times y. So all of these values in amplitude are multiplied by 8. So the overall the amplitude would increase. To make my point more evident, let me use an exponential function on it. And I'm going to do all this, the processing that I have done before for this new y. Let me enable this sound but disable the second sound to avoid repetition, right? And proceed with the simulation.
We will have so much winning if I get elected that you may get bored with winning.
So you can observe that we have low amplitudes, but at the same time we have high amplitudes which are approaching the amplitude levels well beyond 50. So let us increment the simulation by one step until line 20 to include linear quantization. So for linear quantization, you can observe that all of these amplitudes are now missing in the quantized value, right? So the linear quantizer is preserving the information in these amplitudes which are available over here, but it is missing the information at low amplitudes, and hence it will incur a lot of distortion. Now let us move towards mu law and a law for this signal. This is the mu law, this is the a law. So over here all the four plots are presented. The first one is original, the second one is linear quantized, quantized using mu law, and quantized using a law. So in mu law and a law, we have preserved the information at low amplitudes, whereas for the linear quantizer, we miss the information at low amplitudes, right? So over here, the distortion in these two should be significantly less than the distortion in linear quantizer, To be more specific, using these metrics, the distortion is for linear quantizer 10.5, whereas distortion for mu law is 1.02 and distortion for a law is 1.4721. So that is, for nonlinear quantizer, you have significantly less mean square error as compared to the mean square error for linear quantizer. So in short, depending on the behavior or the pattern of our audio signal or the input signal, the nonlinear quantizer can avoid distortion to a good degree.